Hello, everybody. Now we are going to continue with the integrals. What that means, really, the defined integral A equals to, or yes, A equals to integral S prime of x dx from A to B. Have a function like so, and it is A and it is B in this interval, then that area on this graph and x-axis is the definition of A. This is A. This is the area. Example, from 1 to 2 x prime minus x prime minus 3 x minus 2 divided by x 3 dx. Then and it is x3 minus 3 minus 2 multiplied by x of power by minus 3 dx, which is integral 1 to 2 1 minus 3 x power by minus 2 minus 2 followed by minus 3x dx is x minus 3 divided by 1 minus 2 x 1 minus 2 minus 2 divided by 1 minus 3 x 1 minus 3 varies from 1 to 2. It is 2. It is minus 3 plus 3 multiplied by 2 minus 1. It is 2 minus 2 is plus 1 multiplied by 2 minus 2 minus 1 plus 3 plus 1. This is 2 plus 3 half plus 1. 4 and this is minus 5. (4, 7, 8) minus 20 is minus 12 divided by 4 is minus 3. The area between x-axis and that interval 1 to 2 is minus 3. It's under the x-axis. And we take another example. Is integral now to 1, 0 to 1, x, 1, x2, to minus dx. We put u equals to 2, du is 2, x dx, then x dx is du divided by 2, x dx. And when x is 0, u is 0, then x is 1, u is 1 as well. Then it is from 0, 0 to 1. Integral 2 minus u, 2 minus x, minus minus x 0 is u 2 and x 1 is 1. And this is from 2 1, q 0, by 1 divided by 1 plus 1 half u 1 plus 1 half plus from 1 to 2, which is minus 1 plus 2 plus u 3 2 minus 1 plus 2 minus x 2 from 0 to 1 again, and it is 1 plus 2 minus minus the minus 1, minus 0, and minus, it is 1 minus 2, which is 1 plus. We decided primitive function, and we put u. We have assumed this one and put you back, and this interval goes back to the frame, the original interval, and put it this one minus this one.
Okay.
It was between x and between area between the function and the x-axis. But if we have between function and a line, Then we have this method. We are going to have a y equals to x3 minus plus x2 plus x minus y or plus y, and the line y equals to x plus y. We are going to find how they cross each other. Then this one must be equal to this one to find where they cross each other. Then x3 plus x2 plus x plus 5 equals to x plus 5. These take each other. Then x2 x plus 1 equals 0. Then x is 0 or x equals to minus 1. Then we are going to build integral 0 minus 1 to 0 y minus y, y 1. It's called the y bar. Dx. It is minus 1 to 0 x3 plus x2 dx. It is 1 fourth, 6 fourth plus 1 3, x3 minus 1 0. It is the first, it is 0 minus this one, 1 fourth minus 1 divided by 4 plus 1 third minus 1 divided by 3. It is 1 fourth minus 1 third. Then it is minus 1 twelfth. Minus, it is 1 divided by 12. And the graph is like so. It is a function and it is a function. What is the between two, the area between two two functions? Between two functions is also the same, y1 equals to 2x2 minus x plus 2, and y2 x3 plus 2. Then we are going to cross these two. Then it is y1 equals y2. Then it is x3 plus 2 minus 2 minus 2, x2 plus x minus 2 plus 2. Then it is equal 0, then x multiplied by x2 minus 2, x plus 1, 0, this is x minus 1 divided by 2, then x1 is 0, x2, 3 is 1. Then integral from 0 to 1, y1 minus y2, dx is integral 0 to 1. Minus 1 divided by 2 is 2 minus 1 is 4 and from 0 to 1 then it is this part it is 2 third minus 1 half minus 1 divided by 4 minus 0 0. Then it is the 12, it is 8 minus 6, 2 minus 3. It is minus 1 divided by 12. This is the area. I will to talk about is the volume. Area between this function and x-axis and between those two vertical axes, we rotate around x-axis. Then v, the volume. What is the volume? The volume is the function P is 0 to 1 y to dx, which is P 15 x 2 plus 1 dx. This is 15 P x 4 plus 2 x 2 plus 1 dx equals to 15 P x 5 divided by 5 plus 2 x divided by 3 divided by 3 plus x between 0 to 1. It is 15 p multiplied by 1 fifth plus 2 third plus 1 minus 0, which is 3 plus 10, it is 13 plus 15, 28. It is 28 P. It is 15 and 15 is better. It is 28 P. Okay. This was all in this tutorial, and see you in algebra, linear algebra.